back the decades to the golden era of Sharpies and skinheads, sensitive singer-songwriters and hairy heavy metal rockers, disco, punk, glam, Black Betty, Bama Lamb, bell-bottom jeans, shopping malls, safety pins and disco balls. We're living in the 70s, right here on Rockwiz! Sensational 70s supergroup, Peter Lucky Luscombe, Mighty Mark Ferry, Ashley Naylor, Cleo Renner, the Rockwiz Orchestra. All right, nourished by a diet of Countdown, ABBA, FM radio and Mum and Dad's moratorium marching. She's a child of the universe, no less than the trees and the stars. If anyone has a right to be here, it's Julia Samira!
Hello and welcome to Rockwiz. The 70s, hey, a decade of unanswered questions. Who shot JR? Who killed Bambi? Are you reeling in the years? When Supernaut said they liked it both ways, was that a reference to both colour and black and white TV? A decade when Cliff Richard asked radio stations to stop playing his song Honky Tonk Angel because the title may have referred to prostitution.
When Captain Beefheart's magic band members included Winged Eel Fingerling and Midnight Hat Size, and track one, side two of Lick My Decals Off, Baby, was I Wanna Find a Woman That'll Hold My Big Toe Till I Have to Go.
When Kate Bush released her first two albums at the age of 19, and when the bionic ear was invented, which finally helped Fernando hear the drums. Brian, you had a question, I believe.
Julia, thank you very much. One quick question. Back in the 70s, if you didn't drink alcohol, and you didn't drink Clayton's, what was the drink you had when you didn't have the drink you had when you weren't having a drink? It was a very thirsty decade.
Ladies and gentlemen, looking for Rockwiz's earlier tonight, we combed the audience and they're looking much neater for it. We chose four. Come out, see us and make a smile. Rockwizzes, as I look upon these smiling faces, I feel that we could all be children of the 70s. Ray?
Yes?
Can you share with us a 70s memory?
Mall Town Hall, after I'd done the skinhead at
yes.
a dance.
Yes.
You remember the skinhead?
Oh. Yes.
I got to have a pash, which is another 70s word.
It is. Well, I don't know, I still use it, but then I'm...
To the Buggles, video killed radio star.
Oh.
Ray, could you give us a little touch of the skinhead dance?
Just, certainly.
Just, here we go. If you want to stand, look out.
I love it. Oh, and he's taking centre stage, ladies and gentlemen. Dave O.
Hello, Julia.
What memories do you have of the 70s, I ask myself?
Oh, probably the strongest was finding out that Ozzy Ostrich was pink. And also the the uniforms of the young
doctors. Hang on, but were you colourblind? It was pretty clear he was pink. Oh, you mean gay?
No, he was in black and white.
Oh, black and white. Oh, black and white. Oh, we're going to be really at odds most of the evening. Okay, good, Dave, good. Yes, so he went pink. Fantastic.
He went pink.
Is there a favourite song from the 70s for you?
Yeah, that's a tough one. Probably one that I sang quite recently. And it takes me back to a old primary school fancy dress party when I went dressed as Leo Sayer in his tragic clown phase.
Yeah, tragic,
and it was,
correct.
Long tall glasses.
Long tall glasses, correct. Do you still gear up in the Leo Sayer occasionally?
Yeah, occasionally.
Well, don't bloody do it tonight. That's all I'm asking. Hello, David R.
Hello, how are you, Julie?
Well, I'm very well, thank you for asking. David, what about you, 70s memory?
It would have to be Mickey's Disco, Thursday night's Lower Esplanade, polyester shirt, tight trousers, disco era.
Oh, it's wonderful. Tight trousers, say no more, David. Really, say no more. And it's so wonderful when there is a woman on the team. Please welcome Sarah.
Thank you.
Sarah, what about you? Is there a favourite 70s memory?
Yes, but I was very little, but I remember standing in my bedroom. And look, all I can remember is holding my hairbrush. Yes, cliche, but I did. And I stood there and think, yeah, that's what I want to do.
And what did you sing?
I actually sang songs from War of the Worlds soundtrack.
War of the Worlds soundtrack.
Which is a bit interesting.
We haven't played that on the show yet, and we probably never will. And is your favourite 70s song that wasn't a soundtrack to a strange, deathly story that would frighten children?
No, see, one of my favourite songs from that was Forever Autumn by the Moody... Justin Hayward, that's right.
Yes, yeah. That's right. Do you want to give us a crack of it? A little crack over the...
OK.
Oh, here we go.
The summer sun is fading as the years grow old, and darker days are drawing near.
I'm just being the stars around.
That's so atmospheric.
I'm the War of the Worlds. Ladies and gentlemen, Sarah... Gorgeous. Okay, let's meet the first of tonight's special musical guests by asking the question, which song can it be now? David Byrne said, there were at least four cover versions out at the same time. Foghat, Brian Ferry, Leave on Helm and Us. It's a song that combines teenage lust with baptism. All praise the Mighton Spurton Jesus. Recorded and co-written by Al Green in 1974 and a hit for Talking Heads in 1979, beginning with Don't Know Why I Love Her Like I Do. Yes.
Take Me to the River.
You're a genius. Ladies and gentlemen, to perform that song tonight, please welcome the voice behind the Redfern Now theme and part of the Merry Soul Sessions, the fabulous Kira Puru.
You put me through. You stole my money and my cigarettes. I haven't seen, had no hell to yet. I wanna know, won't you tell me that I love to stay? Take me to the river, wash me down. Won't you cleanse my feet on the ground.
Welcome to you, Kira.
Thank you.
We're delighted to have you back.
Thank you. I'm really happy to be back.
Well, that's the correct answer. Now, Kira, any memories of the 70s? Because I think technically you weren't born.
Technically, I was not born.
Yeah.
But you and I both know that that's not important.
No, it's not. Do you have a favourite 70s song?
Well, I was thinking about this before, and one of my parents' favourite albums was Neil Young's Harvest.
Oh, yeah.
So maybe like Heart of Gold or something,
yes.
You know.
Okay, are you ready to go into the world of the 70s knowing pretty much not much about it?
I was born ready.
Great. Ladies and gentlemen, Kira Puhr,
amazing. Born ready.
Born ready. We have one guest for like a packet of Winnie Blues. There's something else up our sleeve. What song can it be now? Covered by Johnny Cash, Joan Jett and Bonnie Tyler. It was the first single from Pendulum. John Fogerty has said the song's about the fact that while the band was experiencing fame and fortune, somehow everyone seemed unhappy. There was a storm coming, rain coming down on a sunny day. The song's title was in the form of a question, beginning with, have you ever? Yes, my darling.
Seen the rain.
Oh, you're absolutely correct, Sarah. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the man who topped 2013's Hottest 100 with his song Riptide, James Keogh, also known as Vance Joy. Delightful James, hello.
Hello, Julia.
Gee, we're rapt to have you on the program.
I'm very happy to be here.
Good. Now, do you have any memory whatsoever of the 70s, James? Question mark.
No. 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 87 baby.
An 87 baby? Oh, yeah. That's just. And we all felt the knife go in and we've all. Anyway, James, what do you imagine the 70s were?
So, actually, I knew this question was coming and I asked Dad before I left to come here. And he gave me a few things, but what I took mainly was he said, it's like the end of the 60s and the beginning of the 80s. And that's, and I was like, thanks, Dad, that's really, isn't, that's very insightful.
But you, James, when you hear 70s song, you see 70s memorabilia, does it seem completely foreign to you? Is it like a Martian world?
A little bit. I think what I think of is the end of the Beatles and like George Harrison's solo stuff and some of those songs that I think I've started to discover like recently. So
beautiful.
Yeah.
Do you have a favourite 70s song?
At the moment, it would be Give Me Love, George Harrison.
Very nice. All right, now, a 70s soundtrack awaits us. Time to get it on and take it easy. Don't be paranoid and don't get fooled again. You will survive. Round one, local and or general. Let's start with some classics. Complete the titles. Comfortably. Yes.
Numb.
Correct. Born to. Yes.
Run.
Correct. Instant. Yes.
Karma.
Correct, Dave-O, thank you. Don't fear the.
Reaper.
Well, of course, you and your little special T-shirt on, correct? Horse with no.
Name.
Correct. You're so. Yes. Work as a team. Work as a team. Go. Go. Is it correct? Don't give her the wrong answer.
I just said,
Vain.
Correct.
Yes.
Well done.
Beautiful.
You said beautiful, but I didn't know if you were like.
I was only looking at you.
I think he was, Kira. Aladdin.
Same.
Correct, David R. Goodbye to.
Jane.
Very good, David. In 1970, Liv Mason's Knock Knock Who's There hit number 2 on the Go Set charts. Which Welsh artist recorded the original for the Eurovision Song Contest? Yes.
Mary Hopkin.
David R. Round of applause. Mary Hopkins is her name. Whose 1973 live concert was watched on TV by more Americans than the first lunar landing?
I'll say Elvis.
You'd be absolutely correct if you said Elvis. Well played. That's a lot of people, isn't it? I don't think they'd stop for Leo Sayer, I'm wondering. In their 1978 mockumentary, Who Gave Us All You Need Is Cash, Cheese and Onions and Blue Suede Schubert?
The Ruttles.
The Ruttles is correct. Which Australian band changed their name to Highway in America? Yes.
Sherbet.
Sherbet is correct, Ray. True or false? America's National Rifle Association adopted Sherbet's You Got the Gun as their theme tune, sung at the beginning of every NRA meeting. Yes.
False.
Of course it's false.
It's true.
It's not true, Ray. What universe are you living in? Which album held the number one spot in the US for only a week, but remained on the album charts for 741 weeks? Freak has answering the question and I haven't even finished the answer. Your question, yes.
Dark Side of the Moon.
Dark Side of the Moon is absolutely correct. How's that? So you just want to take your clothes off? Oh, no, maybe not. The viewing of which film is said to be enhanced by watching it while listening to Dark Side of the Moon?
Wizard of Oz?
The Wizard of Oz is correct, James.
well.
Have you done it?
No. I was so stoked I answered a question.
I know. Ladies and gentlemen, he's answered a question, yeah. Everybody. Come on. What song was played first on January the 19th, 1975, on Double J radio? Yes.
You just like me because I'm good in bed?
How fucking dare you? You're absolutely correct. Give him a round of applause.
Caught in the bed.
Beautiful. In 1978, who rhymed Ich liebe dich with Rhythm Stick?
Ian Jury.
Ian Jury's correct. Correct these song titles. It's a fun one. You ready? Midnight Train to Dubbo.
Georgia.
Of course it should be. Crazy, correct. Killing Me Softly with Long and Slow Detailed Anecdotes.
With a song.
Yeah.
Yes.
Killing Me Softly with his song, of course. His song was enough to kill, not just the long and detailed anecdotes. Papa was a dental technician.
Rolling Stone?
Papa was Papa a Rolling was Stone, Rolling is correct. Stone. Which 1973 recording by the Edgar Winter Group was used in Wayne's World 2? And shares a title with an 1818 novel by Mary Shelley about a creature created by an unorthodox experiment.
Frankenstein?
Oh, you're very good, aren't you, David? Well played. Orchestra, could you give us 45 seconds of Mr. Winter's monster, please? More before we score. Who performed these 70s instrumentals? Hocus Pocus.
Focus?
Yep.
Yes, you're a poet as well. Very nice. Popcorn.
Hot Butter.
Is what I'm after, correct. Jessica.
The Allman Brothers.
Yes.
Three, yeah. Correct. When the sheet music of Stairway to Heaven was released, did it run to 7, 9 or 11 pages? Yes.
I think 11.
You're right, because it's a bloody long song. Correct. Well played, Sarah. Inspired by Bob Dylan describing his music as having a thin, wild Mercury sound. Which member of the Go-Between said his band had a striped sunlight sound? Yes.
Robert Forster.
Robert Forster is correct. Well played, David. Which Saints single was reviewed in England with the quote, the single of the week and every other week?
I'm stranded.
You are stranded, but you're also correct. Excellent, Dave. Which UK band featuring Captain Sensible and Rat Scabies are said to have released the first punk single?
Dave.
The Damned.
You're absolutely right. Who sang in a song called 1977? No Elvis, Beatles or Rolling Stones in 1977? He's a bit angry. Yes.
The Clash.
It is The Clash. So angry all the time. Which band inspired the Daily Mirror headline, The Filth and the Fury? Yes.
Six Pistols.
Correct. Which of the Pistols got his nickname due to the state of his teeth?
Johnny Rotten.
Johnny Rotten, bless. And now, in the spirit of punk rock, I'm going to do something totally anarchic, right? I'm not going to even bother to introduce Dougald or the scores. Yeah, you heard me, SBS. No introduction to Dougald whatsoever. Without buzzers, where you simply yell out the answers with around half a minute to play. It's just so crazy it might work. But only in a thing called 33 and a third seconds to shine. Shine. Budget cuts, I have to do my own special effects. Let's start with your team, James. Your time starts now. Finish the title. Fly, Robin.
Fly.
Grindstone.
Cowboy.
Most people I know.
Think that I'm crazy.
Wuthering
Heights.
Complete the famous duos Seals and
Cross.
Simon and
Garfunkel.
Delaney and
Bonnie.
Yep.
Oh, old person, correct. Flo. Flo and
Ryder.
Eddie.
Flo and Ryder. Nice.
Lol.
Very good. Who sang these number ones? Me and Bobby McGee. Janis
Joplin. Joplin.
Oh, Maggie May.
Rod Stewart.
Imagine. John Lennon. That was good. Excellent, your ballroom blitzed it. Now, let's see how Kira's team fares. Dave, Kira, Ray, are you ready? Your questions begin now. Finish the title, whole lot of...
Love.
Torn between two...
Lovers.
Chirpy, chirpy...
Cheep, cheep.
I do.
I do.
Complete the famous duos. Captain and...
Tennille.
Crosby and...
Nash.
Loggins and...
Messina.
Who sang these number ones? American Pie.
Don McLean.
Staying Alive.
Bee Gees.
Evie parts 1, 2 and 3.
Stevie Wright.
Ernie, the fastest milkman in the West.
Ernie Hill.
Add a first name to these surnames. Janet Mead.
Sister.
What was that?
Sister.
Sister Janet Mead. Right, a round of applause. Well done, everyone. May the hammer of the gods carve your scores in stone. I'd rather be spaghetti than fettuccine. Yes, I would. If I could, I surely would. Simon and Garfunkel's El Condor pasta. Mm. Great lyrics, sure, yet there's more to a song than just the words, as demonstrated in our next challenge, Million Dollar Riff. Orchestra, riff number one. Yes, David!
I'm stranded by the Saints.
100 million yes. points, you are absolutely correct.
I wish you were here.
Yes, I wish I was here also. That's correct. And who sang it, do you think?
Pink Floyd.
Oh, she's absolutely yes. right. Round of applause for Sarah Gonzalez.
Thank you.
Oh. And finally, riff number three. The ball is with Sarah.
Werewolves of London.
That's right. To perform Werewolves of London, one of our favourite excitable boys, please welcome Tex Perkins.
Thank you.
back a bit later. Oh, look, welcome to you, Tex. Now, the 70s, you must remember the 70s.
I do.
Great. Yes. What's a memory, a fond memory you have of that time?
The recurring memory when I have is my flares getting caught in the chain of my bicycle.
Yes.
It was the fashion of the decade.
Yes.
And I spent a lot of time on that decade on a push bike, so just it was like always flapping. Oh, fuck, I've got the...
Oh, so annoying.
Flares caught in, the spokes sometimes.
Welcome to you, Tex, but we've got a quiz to do and a segment we like to call the middle eight. Eight questions, roughly in the middle. Strap yourselves in, and here we go. If Jagger and Richards were the Glimmer twins, who were the toxic twins?
Joe Perry and Steve Tyler.
Yes. Correct, from the Aerosmith, correct. In 1974, which band was booed off stage at Sunbury because the crowd wanted to see Billy Thorpe and the Aztecs?
Queen.
Queen is correct. Apparently, people in the audience shouted out, "Go back to Pomeland, you poofters!" We're so classy, aren't we? Just full of class. And apparently Freddie Mercury retorted, "When we come back to Australia, Queen will be the biggest band in the world." And they was. What 1974 horror film uses Mike Oldfield's Tubular Bells as its theme?
The Exorcist.
Correct, The Exorcist. Which members of the Partridge Family actually performed the songs? And it wasn't Susan Day, I'm very sad to say. Yes.
Shirley Jones, David Cassidy?
Absolutely
correct.
Yeah. Yeah, come on, that's pretty good. I think I love you, but what am I so afraid of?
Afraid that I'm not sure of a love there is no cure for.
I think I love you.
Very nice. For bonus points, what relationship did David Cassidy and Shirley Jones have in real life?
Lovers.
Oh, they weren't lovers. How disgusting. Yes.
She was his stepmother.
1,000 million
yes.
books. Very good, David.
I think they were getting confused with Greg Brady and Mrs. Brady.
Yes.
They were.
Lovers. Which Australian band chose its name after passing a roadside near Geelong? Yes.
Little River Band.
Correct. Yes. Which LRB song begins, "Why are you in so much hurry? Is it really worth the worry?" Yes.
Hang on. Help is on its way. I'll be there as fast as I can.
Again.
Hang on. A tiny voice did say, somewhere deep inside the inner man.
Oh, that is lovely work.
Yeah. Beautiful harmony. Oh, yeah.
Very nice harmony.
Sweet.
With a distinguished career in the Twilights and Axiom, who was the lead singer of Little River Band? Yes.
Glenn Shorrock.
Correct. Who is waiting backstage to come out and sing?
Glenn Shorrock.
Ladies and gentlemen, to sing the 1977 number one song he wrote in London in the aftermath of the Axiom breakup, accompanied by guitarist Pip Joyce, please welcome Glenn Shorrock.
Why are you in so much hurry? Is it really worth the
don't you forget who'll take care of you. It doesn't matter what you do. Form a duet, let him sing melody. Then you provide the harmony.
It's close. Not as close as that boy and his pet rat in that Michael Jackson song, Ben. Ugh. But close. By the end of this round, on the Bowie cheerfulness scale, one team will be hunky-dory while the other will be low. Oh. Your questions begin...
Now.
Which Melbourne venue hosted Led Zeppelin, Elton John and the Rolling Stones in the 70s?
Festival Hall.
I can't give it to you.
Kooyong?
Kooyong, yes. Is correct. Tennis Centre. Where's Thistle Hall when it's at home?
Festival Hall.
Oh, I thought you said Thistle Hall. I'm going... Where's Thistle Hall?
That's a lovely place.
Is it? Yeah. I'm actually going a bit deaf, Ray, so forgive me.
Sad. You have to work on your mic technique there, Ray.
How do I go, mate? All right?
Just back off a little bit.
Back off.
Right. There.
There.
Oh.
There. There it is.
There.
There it is. Yep.
And then they come... Which Zeppelin song about a battle makes references to Lord of the Rings?
The Battle of Evermore.
Correct. Which Stones song is thought to be about David Bowie's first wife? Yes.
Angie.
Angie. Correct. Say it properly. Angie. Like that. Which Elton John song was about Marilyn Monroe?
Candle in the Wind.
Correct, Sarah. Of course, you might not have heard of the tribute to Mother Teresa in the same ilk, Sandal in the Bin. And it seems to me that you live your life like a sandal in the bin. Dave?
Yes,
what
Julia?
What the hell am I doing all this singing for? When you are gagging.
I gagging. Am gagging, you're correct.
Gagging.
Come on.
To sing a song I've never heard of. Long Tall Glasses by Leo
Sayer. I'm sure you've heard of it.
Come on, Dave.
I'm not a very good falsetto.
Right.
Line, but I'll give it a go.
Give it a crack.
Well, I was traveling down the road feeling hungry and cold. I saw a sign giving food and drink to everyone. Well, naturally, I thought I would take me a look inside. There was so much food, there was water coming from my hands. I'm sure I can dance, I'm sure I can dance, I can dance.
No, I can dance.
No, I can dance. I can dance.
Sorry, I think I came in a bit early there.
Oh, yeah.
Rockwiz. How wonderful. Let's get geographical then. Who sang these hits, More Than a Feeling?
Boston.
Correct. A Horse with No Name. Yes.
America.
Correct. The Final Countdown.
Europe.
Yes.
That was 80s. What's that doing here?
It
what
was.
Is this, that question doing here?
Yeah, that was 80s. That was 80s.
Clearly 80s. We all know.
See you later.
Well,
sorry to be a...
Well, I, Tex, I'm so glad you brought it up because we were just testing to see if you were listening.
Yes.
Well done.
I had drifted off for a little while.
Yes,
but then,
you had.
All
you
right,
had
points for Tex.
Points for Tex.
I'll take 50, thank you.
You'll get 5.
And be happy.
I think this one's from the 70s. Sing the next line. Sing it, okay? Don't just talk it. If you leave me now...
Oh. Come on, Sarah.
Take away the biggest part of me. Ooh, no, baby, please don't go.
Good, more.
More. Ooh, don't... Had to bet you by my side.
You gibberish that, didn't you? But I love a ladies and gentlemen, well played.
<That's a scene.
laughs> Complete and sing the next line. On Hollywood, 7 rooms to rent.
Till your name goes up in lights.
Lights. I like
Hollywood
you.
7, you can dream your dreams of $7 a night.
That's a man. Give a round of applause.
Come on. Can anyone give us a bit more?
She came in one night from Omaha, all strung out, cause she never could sleep on the train.
Yeah.
I think you're gonna take out the text.
And she took a bus to Hollywood. Looking for her in the driving rain.
Oh, yeah. Looking for her, that's it.
Keep going.
With her eyes so blue and hair so brown, she was gonna take this town and turn it upside down.
Hollywood 7 rooms to rest, and your name goes up in lights. Whoa, Hollywood 7, you can dream your dreams for $7 a night.
Ladies and gentlemen,
that is very cheap, we've got to admit.
Yeah, yeah.
A hotel room worth $7.
Oh, I'm sorry. I think so.
What is it, tent?
Oh, here we go. Can you complete this lyric before I lose the will to live? Here we go. I'm joking. They both knew it was wrong, but Billy Paul had a thing going on with himself and Mrs.
Me and Mrs. Mrs. Jones, Mrs. Jones.
Yes, that is absolutely correct.
We got a thing going on. We both know it's wrong, but it might be too strong to let it go now. Sorry.
Okay, now, new section. Mo or no mo? Moustaches were big in the 70s. Answering mo or no mo, tell me if these artists wore a moustache at any time in that decade. Are you ready? Frank Zappa.
Mo.
Correct. Joe Camilleri.
Mo.
No. Correct. Works the team. Joe Walsh.
Mo.
Correct. Joe Cocker.
Mo.
No.
Beard Kid. And...
No, the answers are mo or no, no mo. There's no beard
no,
in
no
this.
Beard.
Yeah.
No mo.
No mo.
No mo, Joe.
John Fogerty.
No mo.
No mo's correct. John Paul Young.
No mo.
No mo. No mo. Not squeak. Correct. Nick Lowe.
No mo. No mo. Nick Lowe. Mo. No. Low.
Yes.
Low.
Yes. No mo, lick no,
all
that's correct.
Right.
No mo, Nick Lowe, you're absolutely
no
correct.
Mo, Nick Lowe.
Okay. Brian assures me that beginning song titles with verbs was a hallmark of the 70s. Complete these titles by adding adjectives, nouns, adverbs, and pronouns. Come up and see me.
Make me smile.
Correct. Play that.
Funky. Funky music.
Correct. Dancing.
Days. I hear again.
No.
70s.
Zeppelin.
Queen.
Dancing.
Dancing Days.
Yeah, Queen, correct.
Oh, Dancing in the Dark.
We're paying that.
Dancing in the Dark, not in the 70s.
No. 80s.
That was
Knock Free.
Times.
Correct. Killing Me.
Softly.
Softly. Oh.
Correct. Touch Me in the Right Place. I don't know.
Morning.
Hang on, hang on. Rewind, rewind. Oh, rewind there. Touch Me in the Right Place. Well, yes. I mean, absolutely. If a woman can't ask, touch me in the right place, where, how far have we actually come with feminism? Well done, you. Touch me in the right place. And, of course, that right place will be different from woman to woman to woman. I think we've all learned something this evening, don't you?
Great.
Shake, 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 shake your...
Booty. Booty.
What?
Booty.
Your booty.
Booty? Say it like
Three,
a
Three, two, shake. One...
Skylab, our teams have done a fantastic job, but there's been a lot of crashing and burning. People, pick up the pieces while Dougal puts up the final scores. And special guests, we say a hearty thanks. And to you at home, drag yourselves out of your beanbags and find us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. Watch us all over again on our website. We leave you with a quote from Tom Waits, who once said, George Bush is a fan of mine. He came to see me in the 70s. His coke dealer brought him. To take us out tonight, Tex, Glenn, Vance and Kira are combining on a song John Lennon released in February 1970. As he said, I wrote it for breakfast, recorded it for lunch and we're putting it out for dinner. Instant karma. Peace, brothers and sisters.
You gonna knock you right on your head. You better get it together, 'cause pretty soon you'll be dead. Gonna get you. It's gonna look you right in the face. You better get yourself together, darling. Join the human race. It's gonna get you. Gonna knock you right off your feet. Yeah. You better forget your brothers.
Shine.
No Mo, no Mo, Nicklo. Mo, no.
741 weeks. Freak has answering the question, and I haven't even finished the answer. Your question, yes.
Dark Side of the Moon.
Dark Side of the Moon is absolutely correct. How's that? Now you just want to take your clothes off? Oh, no, maybe not. The viewing of which film is said to be enhanced by watching it while listening to Dark Side of the Moon?
Wizard of Oz?
The Wizard of Oz is correct, James.
well.
Have you done it?
No. I was so stoked I answered a question.
I know, ladies and gentlemen, he's answered a question, yeah. Everybody. Come on. What song was played first on January the 19th, 1975, on Double J Radio? Yes.
You just like me because I'm good in bed?
How fucking dare you? You're absolutely correct. Give him a round of applause.
Cotton, then.
Beautiful. In 1978, who rhymed Ich liebe dich with Rhythm Stick?
Ian Jury.
Ian Jury's correct. Correct these song titles. It's the fun one. You ready? Midnight Train to Dubbo.
Georgia.
Of course it should be. Crazy, correct. Killing Me Softly with Long and Slow Detailed Anecdotes.
With a song.
Yeah.
Yes.
Killing Me Softly with his song, of course. His song was enough to kill, not just the long and detailed anecdotes. Papa was a dental technician.
Rolling Stone.
Papa was a Rolling Stone, is correct. Which 1973 recording by the Edgar Winter Group was used in Wayne's World 2? And shares a title with an 1818 novel by Mary Shelley about a creature created by an unorthodox experiment.
Frankenstein?
Oh, you're very good, aren't you, David? Well played. Orchestra, could you give us 45 seconds of Mr. Winter's Monster, please? More before we score. Who performed these 70s instrumentals? Hocus Pocus.
Focus?
Yep.
Yes, you're a poet as well. Very nice. Popcorn.
Hot Butter.
Is what I'm after, correct. Jessica.
The Allman Brothers.
Yes.
Freak, correct. When the sheet music of Stairway to Heaven was released, did it run to 7, 9 or 11 pages? Yes. They are so bad. Without buzzers, where you simply yell out the answers with around half a minute to play, it's just so crazy it might work. But only in a thing called 33 and a third seconds to shine. Shine. Budget cuts, I have to do my own special effects. Let's start with your team, James. Your time starts now. Finish the title. Fly, Robin.
Fly.
Grindstone.
Cowboy.
Most people I know.
Think that I'm crazy.
Wuthering
Heights.
Complete the famous duo Seals and
Croft.
Simon and
Garfunkel.
Delaney and
Bonnie.
Yep.
Oh, old person, correct. Flo. Flo and
Ryder.
Eddie.
Flo and Ryder. Nice.
Lol.
Very good. Who sang these number ones? Me and Bobby McGee. Janis
Joplin.
Oh, Maggie May.
Rod Stewart.
Imagine. John Lennon. That was beautiful. Excellent, your ballroom blitzed it. Now, let's see how Kira's team fares. Dave, Kira, Ray, are you ready? Your questions begin now. Finish the title, Whole Lotta.
Love.
Torn Between Two.
Lovers.
Chirpy Chirpy.
Cheap.
I do. Complete the famous duos, Captain and
Tennille.
Crosby and
Nash.
Loggins and
Messina.
Who sang these number ones? American Pie.
Don McLean.
Staying Alive.
Bee Gees.
Evie Parts 1, 2 and 3.
Stevie Wright.
Ernie, the fastest milkman in the West.
Ernie Hill.
Add a first name to these surnames. Janet Mead.
Sister.
What was that?
Sister.
Sister Janet Mead. A round of applause. Well done, everyone. May the hammer of the gods carve your scores in stone. I'd rather be spaghetti than fettuccine. Yes, I would. If I could, I surely would. Simon and Garfunkel's El Condor Pasta. Mm. Great lyric, sure, yet there's more to a song than just the words, as demonstrated in our next challenge, Million Dollar Riff. Orchestra, riff number one. Kira.
Thank you.
We're delighted to have you back.
Thank you. I'm really happy to be back.
Well, that's the correct answer. Now, Kira, any memories of the 70s? Because I think technically you weren't born.
Technically, I was not born.
Yeah.
But you and I both know that that's not important.
No, it's not. Do you have a favourite 70s song?
Well, I was thinking about this before, and one of my parents' favourite albums was Neil Young's Harvest.
Oh, yeah.
So maybe like Heart of Gold or something,
yes.
You know.
Okay, are you ready to go into the world of the 70s knowing pretty much not much about it?
I was born ready.
Great. Ladies and gentlemen, Kira Puhr.
Born ready.
Born ready. We have one guest for like a packet of Winnie Blues. There's something else up our sleeve. What song can it be now? Covered by Johnny Cash, Joan Jett and Bonnie Tyler. It was the first single from Pendulum. John Fogerty has said the song was about the fact that while the band was experiencing fame and fortune, somehow everyone seemed unhappy. There was a storm coming, rain coming down on a sunny day. The song's title was in the form of a question, beginning with, have you ever? Yes, my darling.
Seen the rain.
Oh, you're absolutely correct, Sarah. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the man who topped 2013's Hottest 100 with his song Riptide, James Keogh, also known as Vance Joy. Absolutely correct if you said Elvis. Well played. That's a lot of people, isn't it? I don't think they'd stop for Leo Sayer, I'm wondering. In their 1978 mockumentary, Who Gave Us All You Need Is Cash, Cheese and Onions and Blue Suede Schubert?
The Ruttles.
The Ruttles is correct. Which Australian band changed their name to Highway in America? Yes.
Sherbet.
Sherbet is correct, Ray. True or false? America's National Rifle Association adopted Sherbet's You Got the Gun as their theme tune, sung at the beginning of every NRA meeting. Yes.
False.
Oh, of course it's false.
It's true.
It's not true, Ray. What universe are you living in? Which album held the number one spot in the US for only a week, but remained on the album charts for 741 weeks? Freak has answering the question, and I haven't even finished the answer. Your question, yes.
Dark Side of the Moon.
Dark Side of the Moon is absolutely correct. How's that? So you just want to take your clothes off? Oh, no, maybe not. The viewing of which film is said to be enhanced by watching it while listening to Dark Side of the Moon?
Wizard of Oz?
The Wizard of Oz is correct, James.
well.
Have you done it?
No. I was so stoked I answered a question.
I know. Ladies and gentlemen, he's answered a question, yeah. Everybody. Come on. What song was played first on January the 19th, 1975, on Double J Radio? Yes.
You just like me because I'm good in bed?
How fucking dare you? You're absolutely correct. Give him a round of applause.
Cotton, then.
Beautiful. In 1978, who rhymed Ich liebe dich with Rhythm Stick?
Ian Jury.
Ian Jury's correct. Correct these song titles. It's a fun one. You ready? Midnight Train to Dubbo.
Georgia.
Of course it should be. Crazy, correct. Killing Me Softly with Long and Slow Detailed Anecdotes.
With a song.
Yeah.
Yes.
Killing Me Softly with his song, of course. His song was enough to kill, not just the long and detailed anecdotes. Papa was a dental technician.
Rolling Stone.
Papa was a Rolling Stone, is correct. Which 1973 recording by the Edgar Winter Group was used in Wayne's World 2? And shares a title with an 1818 novel by Mary Shelley about a creature created by an unorthodox experiment.
Frankenstein?
Oh, you're very good, aren't you, David? Well played. Orchestra, could you...
Ashley Naylor! Cleo Renner! The Rockwiz Orchestra! All right. Nourished by a diet of Countdown, ABBA, FM radio and Mum and Dad's moratorium marching. She's a child of the universe, no less than the trees and the stars. If anyone has a right to be here, it's Julia Samira!
Hello and welcome to Rockwiz. The 70s, hey, a decade of unanswered questions. Who shot JR? Who killed Bambi? Are you reeling in the years? When Supernaut said they liked it both ways, was that a reference to both colour and black and white TV? Mm. A decade when Cliff Richard asked radio stations to stop playing his song Honky Tonk Angel because the title may have referred to prostitution.
When Captain Beefheart's magic band members included Winged Eel Fingerling and Midnight Hat Size, and track one, side two of Lick My Decals Off, Baby, was I Want to Find a Woman That'll Hold My Big Toe Till I Have to Go.
When Kate Bush released her first two albums at the age of 19, and when the bionic ear was invented, which finally helped Fernando hear the drums. Brian, you had a question, I believe.
Julia, thank you very much. One quick question. Back in the 70s, if you didn't drink alcohol, and you didn't drink Clayton's, what was the drink you had when you didn't have the drink you had when you weren't having a drink? It was a very thirsty decade.
Ladies and gentlemen, looking for Rockwizzes earlier tonight, we combed the audience and they're looking much neater for it. We chose four. Come out, see us and make a smile. Rockwizzes, as I look upon these smiling faces, I feel that we could all be children of the 70s. Ray?
Yes?
Can you share with us a 70s memory?
Mall Town Hall, after I'd done the skinhead at a dance.
Yes.
You remember the skinhead?
Oh.
Yes.
I got to have a pash. which is another 70s word.
It is. Well, I don't know. I still use it, but then I'm...
To the Buggles, video killed the radio star.
Oh. And special guests, we say a hearty thanks. And to you at home, drag yourselves out of your beanbags and find us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. Watch us all over again on our website. We leave you with a quote from Tom Waits, who once said, George Bush is a fan of mine. He came to see me in the 70s. His coke dealer brought him. To take us out tonight, Tex, Glenn, Vance and Kira are combining on a song John Lennon released in February 1970. As he said, I wrote it for breakfast, recorded it for lunch and we're putting it out for dinner. Instant karma. Peace, brothers and sisters.
You right on your head. You better get it together, 'cause pretty soon you'll be dead.
What in the world are you thinking of? Laughing in the face of love. What on earth are you trying to do? It's up to you, yeah, you.
Instant karma's gonna get you. Gonna look you right in the face. You better get yourself together, darling. Join the human race.
How in the world are you gonna see? Laughing at fools like me. Who on earth do you think you are? The superstar. Well, right you are.
It's gonna get you. Gonna knock you right off your feet.
Yeah. You better forget your brothers.
Career in the Twilights and Axiom, who was the lead singer of Little River Band? Yes.
Glenn Shorrock.
Correct. Who is waiting backstage to come out and sing?
Glenn Shorrock.
Ladies and gentlemen, to sing the 1977 number one song he wrote in London in the aftermath of the Axiom breakup, accompanied by guitarist Pip Joyce, please welcome Glenn Shorrock.
Illusion, sorted out, you beg out.
don't you forget who'll take care of you. It doesn't matter what you do. Form a duet, let him sing melody. Then you provide the harmony.
Wonderful. Let's get geographical then. Who sang these hits, More Than a Feeling?
Boston.
Correct. A Horse with No Name. Yes.
America.
Correct. The Final Countdown.
Europe.
Yes.
That was 80s. What's that doing here?
It
what
was.
Is this, that question doing here?
Yeah, that was 80s. That was 80s.
Clearly 80s. We all know.
See you later.
Well, I'm so glad you brought it up because we were just testing to see if you were listening.
Yes.
Well done.
I had drifted off for a little while.
Yes,
but then,
you had.
All
you
right,
had
points for Tex.
Points for Tex.
I'll take 50, thank you.
You'll get 5.
And be happy.
I think this one's from the 70s. Sing the next line. Sing it, okay? Don't just talk it. If you leave me now... Oh.
Come on, Sarah.
Take away the biggest part of me. Ooh, no, baby, please don't go.
Good, more.
Bah, bah. Ooh, don't. I had to bet you by my side.
You gibberish that, bah, didn't you? But I'm a ladies and gentlemen, well played. Complete and sing the next line. On Hollywood, 7 rooms to rent.
Till your name goes up in lights.
Lights. I like
Hollywood
you.
7, you can dream your dreams of $7 a night.
That's a man. Give a round of applause.
Come on. Can anyone give us a bit more?
She came in one night from Omaha, all strung out, because she never could sleep on the train.
Yeah.
I think you're going to take out of the text. And she took a bus to Hollywood. Looking for her in the driving rain.
Oh. Yeah. Looking for her, that's it.
Keep going.
With her eyes so blue and hair so brown, she was gonna take this town and turn it upside down.
Hollywood 7 rooms to rest and your name goes up in lights. Whoa, Hollywood 7, you can dream your dreams for $7 a night.
That is very cheap, we've got to admit.
Yeah, yeah. That,
a hotel room worth $7.
Oh, I'm sorry, I'm too sorry. Hello and welcome to Rockwiz. The 70s, hey, a decade of unanswered questions. Who shot JR? Who killed Bambi? Are you reeling in the years? When Supernaut said they liked it both ways, was that a reference to both colour and black and white TV? A decade when Cliff Richard asked radio stations to stop playing his song Honky Tonk Angel because the title may have referred to prostitution.
When Captain Beefheart's magic band members included Winged Eel Fingerling and Midnight Hat Size and track one side two of Lick My Decals Off Baby... was I want to find a woman that'll hold my big toe till I have to go.
When Kate Bush released her first two albums at the age of 19 and when the bionic ear was invented, which finally helped Fernando hear the drums. Brian, you had a question, I believe.
Julia, thank you very much. One quick question. Back in the 70s, if you didn't drink alcohol and you didn't drink Clayton's, what was the drink you had when you didn't have the drink you had when you weren't having a drink? It was a very thirsty decade.
Ladies and gentlemen, looking for Rockwiz's earlier tonight, we combed the audience and they're looking much neater for it. We chose four. Come out, see us and make a smile. Rockwiz, as I look upon these smiling faces, I feel that we could all be children of the 70s. Ray?
Yes?
Can you share with us a 70s memory?
Mall, Town Hall, after I'd done the skinhead at a dance.
Yes.
You remember the skinhead?
Oh. Yes.
I got to have a pash, which is another 70s word.
It is. Well, I don't know, I still use it, but then I'm...
To the Buggles, video killed radio star.
Oh.
Ray, could you give us a little touch of the skinhead dance?
Certainly.
Just, here we go. If you want to stand, look out.
I love it. Oh, and he's taking centre stage, ladies and gentlemen. Dave.
Doesn't matter what you do. Form a duet, let him sing melody. Then you provide the harmony.
It's close. Not as close as that boy and his pet rat and that Michael Jackson song, Ben. Ugh. But close. By the end of this round, on the Bowie cheerfulness scale, one team will be hunky-dory, adding adjectives, nouns, adverbs and pronouns. Come up and see me
Make Me Smile.
Correct. Play that.
Funky music.
Correct. Dancing.
Days. I hear again.
No.
70s.
Zeppelin.
Queen.
Dancing.
Dancing Days.
Yeah, Queen, correct.
Oh, Dancing in the Dark.
We're paying that.
Dancing in the Dark, not in the 70s.
No. 80s.
That was
Knock Free.
Times.
Correct. Killing Me.
Softly.
Softly.
Oh. Correct. Touch Me in the right place. I don't know.
Morning.
Hang on, hang on. Rewind. There. Touch Me in the Right Place. Well, yes. I mean, absolutely. If a woman can't ask, touch me in the right place, where, how far have we actually come with feminism? Well done, you. Touch me in the right place. And, of course, that right place will be different from woman to woman to woman.
I think we've all learned something this evening, don't you?
Great. Shake, 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 shake your...
Booty. Booty.
What?
Booty.
Your booty.
Booty? Say it like
Three,
a
Three, two, shake. One...
Like Skylab, our teams have done a fantastic job, but there's been a lot of crashing and burning. People, pick up the pieces while Dougal puts up the final scores. And special guests, we say a hearty thanks. And to you at home, drag yourselves out of your beanbags and find us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. Watch us all over again on our website. We leave you with a quote from Tom Waits, who once said, George Bush is a fan of mine. He came to see me in the 70s. His coke dealer brought him. To take us out tonight, Tex, Glenn, Vance and Kira are combining on a song John Lennon released in February 1970. As he said, I wrote it for breakfast, recorded it for lunch and we're putting it out for dinner. Instant karma. Peace, brothers and sisters.
Gonna get you, gonna knock you right on
in a payphone without any change.
With our sensational 70s supergroup, Peter Lucky Luscombe, Mighty Mark Ferry, Ashley Naylor, Cleo Renner, the Rockwiz Orchestra.
All right, nourished by a diet of Countdown, ABBA, FM radio and Mum and Dad's moratorium marching. She's a child of the universe, no less than the trees and the stars. If anyone has a right to be here, it's Julia Samira!
Hello and welcome to Rockwiz. The 70s, hey, a decade of unanswered questions. Who shot JR? Who killed Bambi? Are you reeling in the years? When Supernaut said they liked it both ways, was that a reference to both colour and black and white TV? A decade when Cliff Richard asked radio stations to stop playing his song Honky Tonk Angel because the title may have referred to prostitution.
When Captain Beefheart's magic band members included winged eel fingerling and midnight hat size, and track one, side two of Lick My Decals Off, Baby, was I Want to Find a Woman That'll Hold My Big Toe Till I Have to Go.
when Kate Bush released her first two albums at the age of 19, and when the bionic ear was invented, which finally helped Fernando hear the drums. Brian, you had a question, I believe.
Julia, thank you very much. One quick question. Back in the 70s, if you didn't drink alcohol and you didn't drink Clayton's, what was the drink you had when you didn't have the drink you had when you weren't having a drink? It was a very thirsty decade.
Ladies and gentlemen, looking for Rockwizzes earlier tonight, we combed the audience and they're looking much neater for it. We chose four. Come out, see us and make a smile.